We're here because we want to see a change. I think that's what's bringing us all together. And of course, that is connected to when the general election is. Dr. Ng asked me that question earlier. I said, I'll save it for the speech. When is the general election? There was a lot of talk about November that is past. Dr. Sri Anwar Ibrahim keeps telling us it's December. I don't believe him, but he's doing that mainly to keep us ready and prepared. But it's very likely to be for March or April. Unless, of course, circumstances start looking unfavorable for them and then they start dragging it out. And it's really an open timetable up to the end of next year. Could be anything from March to October. I think that's realistically what we're looking at. This is going to be, I think, for a lot of us who care for this country, a make or break election. It's going to be a watershed election. It's going to be an election that's going to be far more momentous and historic than what we achieved in March 2008. That's what it's going to be about. And this country will either, this is my own personal view, this country will either go forward and fully develop its capacity, its potential to become one of the great countries of this region, or it can very likely just keep running on the spot, or worse still, regress quite quickly to a possible Burma, a possible Zimbabwe. Our neighbors are not sitting quiet. Indonesia, Vietnam, Thailand, Philippines, whilst they have their own individual problems, inherited and otherwise, but they're moving. Indonesia today, after 10 years from Reformasi in 1998, today is a fairly well-developed democracy. The institutions have developed, have matured, and are strengthening year by year. And we can see that. Whilst they still grapple, for example, with entrenched corruption and so on. Likewise, you know, other countries, Thailand, the democratic institutions have evolved, the Philippines, and economically, they're starting to see the impact of that democratizing, the transition towards democracy. Indonesia, for example, is poised to grow economically, tapping its huge population, its large middle class, you know, drawing investment. Likewise, these other competitors, Vietnam, Philippines, Thailand, are drawing investment. And there's a real danger that our natural advantages, or the advantages that natural meaning the wealth of this country, the bounty of this country, which is in our oil, gas, and our agriculture, the talents of our people, which probably form the greatest cultural mix in the world, these we may be just giving away and not maximizing it to the full potential. So this is what, for me, the general election is going to be about. And I'm sure the next question for some of you is, well, what are our chances? That's the question everybody's focusing on. Are we going to make it? Are we not going to make it? That's a harder one. It's a harder question to answer. A lot of it will depend on what we collectively do. Some of us are already at it because that's what we've committed to do. The frontline work, going to the ground, handling the issues, spreading the message. And those who have a vested interest in making sure there's no change are, of course, putting all the obstacles in front of us. Starting from the media, and then, of course, using all the institutions, the police, the judiciary, you know it all. I'm not going to stand here and explain it, because that's something you know very well. But that does not mean that change cannot happen. Interestingly enough, I think, and later I think we'll hear from Dr. Sri Anwar about what he feels is a sense of the pulse of the ground. What is the feeling on the ground? But my sense of it is, sometimes when I'm following him around in events or doing our own events on the ground, I think we're reaching a point where there is today a majority of the people of this country who want to see a change. I think that is there. Very quickly, I just break it down into racial groups. If we compare the mood between today and March 2008, the support from the Chinese community, without any doubt, and our opponents cannot deny it, has bumped considerably from March 2008 to today. And they know that, and they are worried. They've written off MCA, Garaka, these are irrelevant. They need to get back that support. They just don't know how, and I don't think they ever will. I think the Chinese community has made up its mind, is just waiting for the day to vote. What about the Indians? The propaganda on the ground is that, no, the Indians have gone back. Hindraf is over, it's broken up, it's weak, and the Indians have gone back to MIC. I want them to carry on believing that. Because that's not what it's like on the ground. Rajasri Anwar and a few other leaders, we went down to Klang for Deepavali, we went down to Brickfields. I recently had a Deepavali event in my constituency in Banavaru, Sungai Buloh, and I tell you, the feeling is different. We may have lost a couple of percent, 2-3%, but it's not anything significant that's going to shift the numbers of 2008. So the key battle, and I think this is what you're seeing in the media propaganda that Utusan and TV Tiga rolls out, the key battle is about the Malay vote. And I think that's something a lot of us need to appreciate. That the issues that are being played by UMNO, by Perkasa, you know, that entire group, is about strategies for the Malay vote, because that's, for them, that's what's going to, they're going to use to try to salvage their situation and to perpetuate their current situation. So I think that's an understanding all of us need to develop. And it's the handling of those issues that is also critical, whilst at the same time, we look at what the concerns of the non-Muslim, non-Malay community is also about. The Indians, the Chinese, and of course the communities in Sabah and Sarawak. Just a final perspective before I wrap this speech up is to, because again, about back to the question, will we achieve change in the general election? We did March 2008 and we achieved 82 seats. Then of course we lost Ulus Langau, we won Kuala Terengganu. Then we had our Kataks, the Katak Lompat phenomenon. But I'm not worried about that, because frankly, all of those seats would be won. If there's any one prediction I can make confidently, is about that. Every seat where any of them jumped, that seat will be won. If you're asking me about any state that we will win, without talking about Selangor first, I'll say Perak, we are winning. Because that's the mood about that phenomenon. The issue is about the numbers. I'm going back to the numbers now. If you wind back a bit in time and go back to the time we won Kuala Terengganu, and this is something people may not appreciate so easily, eh? The Malaysian Parliament is 222 seats. 165 seats of those 222 are in Semenanjung Malaysia. 57 are in Sabah and Sarawak. Now, I'm going to look at the 165. If we go back to the time we won Kuala Terengganu, we were 81 to their 84. It's neck to neck. Our popular vote in Semenanjung is actually higher than what was achieved by Barisan Nasional. So basically, they're sitting in Putrajaya, they're running this country simply because of the 55 seats that they have out of the 57 in Sabah and Sarawak. That's really what it is. Their hold on power is basically focused there, which is why the September 16 whole episode was something terrifying for Barisan Nasional. And which is why the Sarawak state election itself has produced a result which is terrifying for them. Because today, just extrapolating from the Sarawak state election itself, just looking at those results, we're looking at about 8 to 9 parliamentary seats already, compared to our current 2. So talks of two-thirds, regaining two-thirds majority are all a dream for them. Now it's for the Barisan simply holding on to a simple majority. But if the mood in Sarawak continues to build, and there's no reason why it should not build, and if the mood in Sabah continues to build, and again, there's no reason why it should not build, a dozen seats in each state is already going to see them in a really, in a pretty much a very difficult situation. And then, of course, you have the phenomenon. This is what we call the September 16th phenomenon of individuals within the ruling coalition who are then going to relook at their situation, parties within the ruling coalition who are going to relook at their situation and see whether they should be forming new alliances to forge new coalitions to run this country. So, what I'm trying to say is, because some of us may have this very pessimistic understanding of the potential for change, that this country, that Barisan National is entrenched forever, that the hegemony they have over the media, their control over the institutions means no change can ever happen. Or even if change happened, it's going to take us not just the next general election, it's going to take us perhaps three more elections. Ladies and gentlemen, believe me, I don't believe in that. I believe this next 1 year, we are going to see change. It's the question of how much of that change. Are we going to get to 100 seats? Are we going to get to, we need 112. That's the figure for a majority of one seat in parliament. But of course, you don't want to go into parliament with a one seat majority. That's too precarious. You want at least 120. And that's doable. It's not something that's a figment of imagination, which perhaps 4 years ago, before 2008, if any one of us had talked to you and said, you know, I'm in the opposition, I'm in party guideline, and we're going to get 120 seats, you would have said, okay, yeah, carry on dreaming. But that's not the case anymore. So, ladies and gentlemen, tonight, I hope that tonight we will, this is the vision that we want to share with you. This is the vision that we want to carry you with. And we want you to see that vision, this vision is not just a mere vision. This is a doable act. And something we can all do together if we all play our respective parts. We understand that not everybody can play the part that some of us play. That's quite understandable. But the message that everybody has got to get involved in this in some way is what we want to share tonight, or at least I want to share tonight.